IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Basketball Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, Standing Stone Bank, Sheridan Funeral Home, Fairfield National Bank, The Huddle Tire Company, Fairfield DD, Personal Touch Party Rentals, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Lines Auto Service, the Carriage Company, Kumler Collision,
Adam H., Dagger Law,
Kirkbride Lawn Care, and Infinitely Outdoors.
And good evening, everybody. Welcome to the High School Basketball Game of the Week. Tonight we're at Falcon Gymnasium for a Mid-State League Buckeye Division girls matchup between the Lady Falcons of Fairfield Union and the Lady Bulldogs of Bloom Carroll High School. I'm Jared Stewart alongside Tim Shoemaker. And Tim, this is a good matchup. These two teams met just a little over a month ago. Fairfield Union won 58-45, but these are two teams very similar coming into tonight's ballgame.
You know, at least record-wise, the division of this Mid-State League with on the girls' side has been very strong. When you look at Amanda, who's got a chance to wrap up the championship tonight, Liberty Union's had a very nice team. These two teams, Circleville, it's been very, very competitive, the whole division. So it's going to be interesting tonight as both teams are looking to have a winning season. And this is the last game of the regular season for the Falcons and the next to last game for the Bulldogs.
As we continue on the Personal Touch Party Rental pregame show, let's talk about these two teams coming in. Very similar, as you mentioned, in record. Fairfield Union 11-10 overall, 7-6 in the Mid-State League Buckeye. Bloom Carroll 11-9 overall, 6-7 in the Buckeye. Both teams coming off of a loss in their most recent game, but both of them close games.
Exactly. And, you know, Carroll's going to look for more tempo control. You spoke with the Fairfield Union side, and you know, they want to get the ball up. Coach Stedman, they want to push the ball and have more opportunity in the open floor. I think Chad Little at Bloom Carroll would like to control tempo and dictate a little more. So it's going to be a contrast in styles a little bit. So that's also going to be interesting for us to watch. So,
and it is senior night here at Falcon Gymnasium. And as we before we get to the game, we certainly want to say congratulations to the seniors at Fairfield Union. We got to see them recognized before the game. They are Katie Isles, who is a senior. She's going to be going to COTC studying sonography. Also, it's the other senior would be, no, I'm sorry, Natalie Thurston is going to COTC. Katie Isles is going to OU to study sports medicine and physical therapy. And then the final senior for Fairfield Union is Cora Gornall, who's going into the U.S. Air Force Academy. So congratulations to those three seniors on a special night tonight.
Yeah, very impressive. And I always enjoy that, Jared, being able to be in our schools here and recognize those players that are graduating and knowing what they're going to do with their future.
And then you look over at Bloom Carroll's side, they have one senior on their roster. That's Alexis Birchfield, who's played a big role in this team this year. But a very young team Coach Little has, and a lot of those young girls have stepped up this year.
Well, you look at that, and you look at the JV team, who just won their 18th game of the season tonight. You know, Coach Little's got to be kind of smiling inside. And actually, you know, if they can get a win here in one of the next two games, they'll have a winning season, and then you have everybody back but one player. That's got to make you feel pretty good.
Throughout the night, we're going to get a chance to talk about these two teams, where they go from here. Tournament's coming up. Kind of interesting how Central District differs from Southeast District. Fairfield Union will be playing next week. Bloom Carroll will have a week to prepare for their tournament game. The tip-off tonight brought to you by Sheridan Funeral Home. The Sheridan family and staff have been serving the communities of Lancaster and Fairfield County for over 100 years. Contact Sheridan Funeral Home at 740-653-4633 to set up an appointment with a caring professional. And we are underway from Falcon Gymnasium. It is the Falcons controlling the tip. Left side. Malin Sunkel. Gives it now to Isles at the top. Man-to-man defense from Bloom Carroll, looks at early on, and that one goes out of bounds. It'll go to the Bulldogs. Falcons are going to come with a full-court pressure. It's
It's man-to-man, Jared.
Mackenzie Mason, 5'3" freshman, will run the offense at the point guard position for the Bulldogs. Here's Alexis Birchfield. Nice backdoor cut. Couldn't hit her. Loose in the corner, and it goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Bulldogs. Corner inbound pass coming from Elena Ireland. Mason now down to the corner to Birchfield. Birchfield goes baseline. A little up and under, no good. Backside rebound put back, no good for Chloe Davis. 0-0, 7:07 and counting here in the first period. Left side for the Falcons. It's Natalie Thurston. To the corner to Sunkel. Little jump shot put up inside the paint, no good for Gornall. Put back, no good for Qualls. And on the jump ball, it'll go back to Bloom Carroll.
One thing I know, Jared, with this crew tonight, they're going to let them play. It, yeah. You know, if somebody gains an advantage, it'll be a foul call. But overall, this crew tends to let people play.
Fairfield Union will stay with that full court pressure defense. Birchfield will bring it up. Here's Robinson being guarded by Katie Isles. Robinson strong to the hole, and they're going to call block on Maylin Sunkel.
Yeah, I think that's the right call.
So it'll be Bulldog basketball underneath their own hoop. Ireland inbound. Gets it in. Nice jump stop. Megan Robinson, the fake. Gets her own rebound. This time it's blocked, but controlled by Bloom Carroll. Birchfield now to the hoop. Can't get it to go. Here come the Falcons. Still 0-0. Almost 2 minutes into this ball game. Nice ball handling. Maylin Sunkel going to the hoop and puts it up and in.
That's an impressive drive. Crossed it over and put it in her left hand. Strong drive to the basket.
It goes Mason coast to coast. What a block right there for Natalie Thurston. They'll get it back inside to Chloe Davis, and she traveled with the basketball. Chloe Davis is one of the players that Coach Stedman said they need to key on tonight. She played very well against the Falcons in their first matchup. 2-0 Fairfield Union, 5:42 and counting here in the first period. Sunkel gives it off to Qualls. Loose ball, Qualls controls. Nice move by Qualls, and she's going to be fouled. She'll get two free throws.
You know, the interesting thing with Chloe, she's just a 6'1 sophomore, and she's got a really big upside as far as to make improvements and to stand out.
Foul's called on Alexis Birchfield. That's her first. Catherine Qualls to the free throw line to shoot two shots. First one, no good.
Isn't it interesting for a relatively good crowd how quiet it is?
Yeah, it is. 3-0 Fairfield Union. And a steal. And no good. And a whistle. What do we have? A timeout? A little mix up here. I don't know if the far official thought that a timeout was called on the inbound pass or not. So apparently it was inadvertent. He thought he heard timeout, so he blew the whistle and called it. But now they're going to give Fairfield Union the ball underneath their own hoop.
That's the right call. He got it right. And that's the most important thing.
Inbound pass comes in to Isles. Get it around to Thurston. Now inside. Catherine Qualls can't handle it. Stolen away by Mackenzie Mason. Coach Little desperately hoping his girls can get on the board here in this trip. 3-0 the score. In jeopardy of a 5-second call. They finally get rid of it. over to Birchfield.
Yeah, the Fairfield Union girls working really hard defensively, Jared. Overplay.
And there's a steal. It's Maylin Sunkel. She'll get two free throws. A lot of coaching experience over on that Fairfield Union bench. Along with Coach Stedman, you've got Coach Burke, who coaches the JV team. A lot of coaching experience with him, not only in basketball, but baseball as well. And, of course, Coach Barr, several years as a boys varsity coach and heck of a player himself.
Yes, he was. And, you know, you're right. And it's always good to have a different set of eyes to help you work as a crew, as a staff. And that's a big advantage, yeah. I think, for Coach Stedman.
Sunkel hits both free throws, 5-0 with 4:50 to play here in the first period. Birchfield gets it across the timeline. Here's Robinson going baseline. Kick it back out. Birchfield to fire up a three. No good. Good hustle for the rebound. Ball's loose. And a whistle and a foul going to be called, I believe, on Bloom Carroll. They call it on Chloe Davis. That's her first.
It's always tough when you can't score, Jared. And, you know, that was a nice look, had a good look. And, you know, you got to make sure you minimize the frustration level in the players.
Maddie Wyant checks in. Uh-oh. The receiver was going one way. The quarterback was going thinking the other.
Yeah, that went into the Fairfield Union student body.
5-0, 4:26 to play in the first period. Mason picks up her dribble, gives it off to Birchfield. Back to Mason. Mason inside the paint, kick it out to Vollmer. Now back to Mason. Good defense by the Lady Falcons.
They've been really good in their man pressure here. Just consistent pressure in the ball, overplaying passes, and forcing Bloom Carroll out of their rhythm.
Back out front to Vollmer. She'll get it over to Birchfield. Thought about the shot. Didn't take it. You hear Coach Little yelling reverse. She was in jeopardy there of a five-second call. And kick it over now to Maddie Wyant. And ball tipped. Wyant controls it. Here's a steal once again. It's Sunkel. That's a couple of them tonight already for Maylin Sunkel.
She's very active defensively.
And a whistle and a double dribble going to be called. So 3:12 to play in the first period. Bloom Carroll still looking for that first bucket. They trail 5-0. Mason gives it off to Birchfield. Back out now to Robinson.
See, their cuts and their screens are just a little slow against the pressure. You got to be a little more aggressive in your cutting to open up those reversal passes and then look to drive it in the open floor. See, the open paint is very open, but unfortunately, they're just a little slow in their movement.
That ball sails out of bounds. It'll go to Fairfield Union.
This is a young team, as you talked before, and you know, sometimes they're going to be susceptible to pressure.
Coach Little will call a timeout, and that'll give us a chance to say thank you to several sponsors who are on board with us this year, Shu.
Let's say thanks to Fairfield Medical Center, improving quality of life through patient care and education. Fairfield Medical Center is people you know and care you trust. And let's say welcome home to Ohio University Lancaster Pickerington. With over 250 Ohio University majors to choose from, you can receive a high-quality education taught by faculty that care about your success and at half the price of most other schools. Apply today at ohio.edu/Lancaster and earn the degree and exciting career that you've always wanted.
And our timeouts tonight are brought to you by the Carriage Company. Make sure you check them out. Always great selection of cars at the Carriage Company. And we also want to tell you, as you see at the bottom of the screen, as always, Buffalo Wild Wings is our scoreboard sponsor. Thanks to Larry Tipton and the gang for great food, great service, and the best sports viewing in town. It's all at Buffalo Wild Wings in the Plaza Shopping Center on North Memorial Drive. Out of the timeout, it's Fairfield Union basketball. Ball's tipped. It'll be controlled by Allie Thompson. She'll get it to Thurston. check that. It's Cat Qualls for Fairfield Union number four. Here's Gornall. Little jump shot, no good. Rebound tipped and controlled by the Bulldogs.
See, right now, you got to have somebody to reverse it to keep the rhythm and offense going. You shouldn't have to reset because when you reset, it resets the defense also.
Malin almost had another steal. Kicks that one out of bounds.
You know, some people call it secondary break. Some people call it, second offense, whatever they call it. But you want to keep the ball moving in that situation.
Uh-oh, there's Sunkel again. This time she can't control it. Tips it out of bounds. Maddie Wyatt will inbound the ball for Bloom Carroll. Gets it into Mason. That ball's tipped right back to Mason. And a whistle and a foul going to be called on Fairfield Union. Called it on Natalie Thurston. So Haley Vollmert will inbound. Gets it to Wyatt. Now to Birchfield.
And what's good about the Fairfield Union girls defense, Jared, is not only are they denying and are playing, they're helping each other well. And that means they've been well taught.
Fairfield Union foul goes on Katie Isles. That's her first. That'll send Mackenzie Mason to the free throw line to shoot two shots.
And from the offensive standpoint, that's what Bloom Carroll needs to do. You need to swing it a little faster and then look to put the ball on the floor and get to the rim because with their overplay, they might be a step slow to help. And they did a really nice job there breaking down the defense.
First free throw good for Mason. Elena Ireland checks back into the ball game for the Bulldogs. Second free throw also up and good for Mackenzie Mason. They're on the board, 5-2, Falcons lead. 1:40 and counting here in the first period. Nice crossover by Sunkel. We'll get it right side now to Isles. She wasn't shy to take that one, was she?
No, shot it with confidence.
Yeah. 8-2 the score. Here's Birchfield, quickly across the timeline. Birchfield goes baseline, is picked up right there, and ball stolen away. Sunkel quickly the other way. Isles again, now to Sunkel. Skip pass over to Thurston. Nice head fake, and Thurston can't get the shot to go, but nice hustle by Natalie Thurston to get her own rebound and put back.
Real good.
10-2 the score, under a minute to play in the first. Mason picks up her dribble and she traveled.
Cool. Yeah, just showing their youth a little bit, Jared, dealing with the ball pressure and just understanding that how to take your time. Fairfield Union girls heads that ball screen really hard and then she picked her dribble up immediately. And that's what you want defensively, them to pick the dribble up because now they're at 30 feet away from the basket.
Hannah Burnside and Katie Burke check into the ball game for Fairfield Union. Here's Burke. She'll kick it back out to the corner to Burnside, down to 15 seconds. Down to 11.
Yeah, you want to start it at 8.
And ball goes out of bounds. It'll stay with Fairfield Union with 6.7 on the clock. So Burnside will inbound. Isles will take the three. No good. And rebounded by Mason with 2 seconds. And that's how time's going to run out here in this first period. 10-2, Fairfield Union on top of Bloom Carroll. Boy, a first period that Coach Little and his girl would just like to put behind them.
Well, they got to the line, got a couple points, so. The good news is they've played relatively good defense, and you've only given up 10 points.
Yeah.
The bottom line is, though, you've got to score some points to win the ball game. And like I said, I think it's just about dealing with the ball pressure that Fairfield Union's applied, getting the ball swung a little quicker from side to side, and then attack the basket off the dribble. They've really got them out of rhythm, Jared. They're playing far from the basket. You can tell they're a little uncomfortable dealing with the ball pressure.
Let's talk about the districts that these two teams are in. Fairfield Union in the Southeast District, they will play in their first tournament game coming up next week. They'll play against Vinton County at Logan High School, while Bloom Carroll in the Central District, they have to wait an extra week, and they'll play on the 24th of February against Johnstown. They get to host that game.
Yeah, and fortunately for Bloom Carroll, they have a game next Wednesday,
right,
I believe, against Buckeye Valley. So, you know, it's not like you have to sit that whole time. They still go through their preparation and get ready and stay sharp. And, you know, the interesting thing is if you look at the Southeast District bracket, which Fairfield Union, it's a tough bracket.
Yeah.
Those are good teams.
Yeah.
And you know, but you should play good teams. If you're going to move on, you have to play well and play good competition. And it'll be interesting to see how that all plays out down in the Southeast.
And they've played some of those Southeast teams,
sure,
as
have.
Well as, you know, teams here in their own division or in their own league, with Amanda Clear Creek and Liberty Union, both very tough this year.
Yeah, well, you know, we had looked at some information. They've played a really good schedule from Southeast teams, East teams, and Central teams.
Yeah.
Fairfield Union's had a tough schedule, so they've really had relatively a really successful season.
Falcons getting into Katie Burke. She'll fire up a three on the inbound. No good. Rebounded by Chloe Davis. Here they come quickly up the floor. And the layup up and in for Maddie Wyant.
See, that as a coach, that drives you crazy. You got to have defensive balance, and that means if the point guard shoots, the other guard's got to be back to make sure nobody gets behind him. It's kind of like the safety in football. You cannot allow anybody to get behind you.
Here's Burke. She'll get it into Josephine Burke. Now back to Katie Burke. Burke, nice move to the hoop. Puts it up and in.
Now you know who that is. That's Coach Burke's daughter.
Right.
And that's a really nice move right there. Using her left hand and then scored it with the right hand because she had to protect it. Very nice move by Katie Burke.
Not only Coach Scott Burke's daughter, but Coach Gary Burke, granddaughter.
Yes.
Who's coached girls basketball for several years, and I think he even coaches Katie in the summertime on her AAU team.
And let's make sure we mention Mom, Amy, because I don't want to go there.
It all starts with Mom.
Yeah, absolutely.
Shot no good for Chloe Davis, rebounded by the Falcons. Natalie Thurston the other way. Gives it off to Burnside, skip pass over to Isles. Her shot no good, and it goes out of bounds. It'll go back to the Bulldogs. Chloe Davis, here they come, quickly up the floor. There's a replay of that last
and
the
layup
for Bloom Carroll. Just beat him up the floor.
Yeah, you know, and as I said before, defensive balance, you have to have somebody back and not let them get behind you. And that's just communication. When one of the others drives or shoots, the other one has to be back.
Tonight's replay is brought to you by Kumler Collision and Automotive. Ball tipped on the inbound. It'll stay with the Bulldogs.
This is smart by Fairfield Union to get up the floor. They're not really gambling. Actually, Bloom Carroll's turned it over a couple times. But to make them handle the ball versus this pressure 90 feet.
Wyant quickly up the floor. Get it out to Burnside, or check that, Birchfield. There's a look at Coach Little over on the side. Birchfield's shot blocked. It's into the hands of Chloe Davis, who puts it up and in.
Well, the key to that is Maddie Wyant's giving him a little lift here, Jim, because she can handle the ball.
Yep.
And they're a little closer to the basket, a little more rhythm offensively.
Here's Burke, right side. Nice bounce pass into Burnside. Burnside's shot, no good. Josephine Burke with the rebound and put back, no good. And now Mackenzie Mason with the rebound. Robinson tries to get it inside. It's loose. Picked up by Sunkel. Long three-pointer put up and drained for Hannah Burnside.
You know, Hannah led them in scoring the first time against Bloom Carroll.
15-6. 5:25 and counting here in this first half. Wyant gets it out.
You got to swing the ball.
Yep.
She held it too long. It's freezing.
And almost lost it there. Regains control and picks her dribble up way out near the half court line. Hard pass there. Chloe Davis not able to control it, and it's out of bounds.
Just distance.
There's that last three, I believe. Had plenty of time to eye it up.
Yeah, but the key is you still have to make it. That's good focus.
15-6, 4:53 and counting here in this second period. Hannah Burnside, lob inside. Now back to Burnside, skip pass over.
Good job of swinging the ball because they were double teamed in the post.
Burnside will fire up another three. This one hits nothing but a nice rebound by Evie Wolfshire. Her shot doesn't go, and here comes Birchfield. Nice quick ball movement that time. Shot put up no good for Chloe Davis. Megan Robinson, I think she was surprised it was that wide open. She hesitated, and that allowed Fairfield Union to regain a spot there on the baseline.
Yeah, she didn't see Chloe Davis on the backside wide open.
Here's Birchfield, one-on-one with Katie Burke. Birchfield to the hoop, puts it up and in, and she's fouled.
Yeah, Katie either got to let her go there or hit her hard enough that she can't score the points. And that's a nice job by Bloom Carroll getting out on transition and scoring. And Alexis Birchfield did a good job of protecting the basketball on the drive to the basket.
Natalie Thurston comes back into the ball game for Fairfield Union. Olivia Roush comes in as well. So Birchfield at the free throw line trying to complete the three-point play, and she does so.
You know, not one Carroll girl is averaging double figures. They really spread their scoring. And you know, we talked about them being a young team. That's good because they have a JV group coming up that's had success.
There's a block for Chloe Davis, but it goes into the hands of Natalie Thurston.
It's the advantage of being 6'1".
Yeah. Thurston's shot no good. She hustled for the rebound, but it went right into the hands of Wyant. And here come the Bulldogs. They've
see how she looks
managed
up the
to get
floor.
Back into the game.
Well, Maddie's the key there for them.
Three-pointer no good. Rebounded by Sunkel. She'll get it over to Wolfshire. Now Burnside. Burnside goes baseline on Birchfield. Had to try to get rid of it and just kind of throws it away. And now it's tied up and it'll go back to Bloom Carroll. So Bloom Carroll climbing back into this one. Down 6 at 15-9. With 3:19 to play in the first half.
See, that's smart right there. Now you got to get it moved right now. She's got to keep moving it. There you go. Now you can get into your offense and get some rhythm and flow.
There's Birchfield. Nice pass inside. Shot put up by one in.
Bulldogs are back in the game,
Jared. Yes, they are. Maddie Wyant has come in off the bench and scored four quick points. A 5'3" sophomore has got him back to within four.
Yeah, but the key is her ball handling. She's allowing the team to gain some confidence offensively with her ball handling.
Roush gives it off to Burnside. Back to Burnside. Sunkel will fire up a three from the top of the key and drain it.
She's a good player, Jared.
7 points for Maylin Sunkel.
You know, she made two free throws at the end of regulation last week to send the game in overtime. You know how hard that is to step up for a young player?
Ball tipped and loose on the floor. Nice job by, who was that? Was it Wyant?
Yes.
Wyant was able to grab it while she was laying on the floor and just found Birchfield wide open.
Digging
who puts
it
up and in. So some substitutions coming in for both teams. Some fresh legs. 18-13 is a score. Just over 2 minutes to play in the first half.
Ball tipped and loose on the floor. Nice job.
Roush gives the left side to Thurston.
Was it Wyant? Yes.
To Qualls. Now around Wyant to the right side to Callie Dennison, who's just checked in for the Falcons.
Was laying on the floor and just found Birchfield wide open.
Roush on the drive to the block and loses it. Here comes Mackenzie Mason. And she'll have it stolen away, but she hustles after it. And now picked up by Dennison. Dennison gets it off to Thurston.
Nice
dump inside. Sunkel puts it in.
High low. And May Lynn's working really hard in the post, Jared, keeping her hands up so she doesn't push off, and did a nice job of pinning her player, and they cleared it out with a four out, one in.
We have a whistle and a...
I think...
going to have a replay as we have another inadvertent
whistle. Watch here. See the space? There's no help.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. That's a beautiful setup of high-low. Yeah, Ken Krebs, I don't know if Coach... they're laughing about it. If Coach Little's saying, take your time, and he thinks he's saying time. I did that once in high school.
Really?
Coach told me take my time, so I told the official time. He wasn't real happy with me.
Sunkel travels with the basketball. They'll give it back to Bloom Carroll, under a minute to play in the first half.
To their credit, they chuckled about it and move on.
That's got to be a tough one. You know, and you watch football games, and some of those times those guys are giving the signal to huddle up.
Yep.
Sometimes it looks like timeout, you know? Nice pass over to Chloe Davis, who finishes it.
But they're beating the pressure a little better right now. You know, they've scored, you know, 13 points this quarter.
Sunkel back the other way.
Yep. She's just going to make it happen for them offensively. She can do it. She did it a lot. She did it in the post. She did it off the dribble. And she's done it off the set, so she's shown all three ways to score.
Mason's shot no good. Put back no good for Davis.
Yeah, I like to see Chloe use the backboard there, Jared.
There's a pass into Qualls. Now back out to Roush. Swing it around to Dennison. Now to Sunkel. If I'm the Falcons, that's who I want to have the basketball with the last second shot.
Well, you know, I don't know how well they can, and they're not going to run it out. That little hook there.
It's tipped out of bounds. It'll stay with Fairfield Union. 6.6 to play in this first half. Roush gets it into Dennison, and it's loose down to 4 seconds. Back over to Roush. And she just heaves one up.
She was clock aware, though. Can't blame her for that.
So time runs out here in this first half. Fairfield Union leads Bloom Carroll 22-15. Stay tuned. Our halftime sponsor are Frank E. Smith Funeral Home and also North Body Shop. At North Body Shop, they've been providing quality customer service, parts, and reliability since 1979. Stop by and see Mark North at 2067 East Main Street in Lancaster. He'll provide you with a free written warranty on each estimate. That's Mark North of North Body Shop. He'll treat you right. Again, Fairfield Union 22, Bloom Carroll 15. We're going to take a timeout. When we come back, we'll have some first half stats and analysis and all second half action coming up on the IVP High School Basketball Game of the Week.
For nearly 90 years, Kumler Collision and Automotive has shown a commitment to excellence with decades of experience and a passion for auto and body repair. Over the years, we've been a big part of seeing this community grow. Our employees are dedicated, hardworking members of this community and care about our customers long after they leave. Kumler Collision and Automotive. We're your neighbors, your friends, and if it's important to your family, it's important to ours.
The Frank E. Smith Funeral Home and Crematory in Lancaster and the Johnson Smith Funeral Home in Baltimore have a long and wonderful history of serving our community. Feel free to give us a call at 740-653-0652. Stop in and see us at either of our two locations, 405 North Columbus Street in Lancaster or 207 South Main Street in Baltimore. Respect for tradition, regard for change.
At Dagger Law, we have more than 110 years of combined expertise in nearly every part of law.
What I think sets us apart from any other law firm is our ability to work together.
With us, you're getting a trusted partner, in addition to a team who can help you with a growing business, changing family, planning your future, or dealing with land issues.
It's a challenge every day, and you meet an awful lot of nice people.
Your case matters. We'll take the time and the energy to ensure that you have a quality experience, quality representation.
Whatever you need, we have a lawyer who can help. Dagger Law. Local. Trusted. Experienced.
I'm Carol Whittington, and I would like to invite you to stop by Personal Touch Party Rentals and Events, located at 1540 Hubbard Drive in Lancaster. We are a small family-owned business and have been servicing the Central Ohio and Hocking Hills area since 2003. Graduations with a personal touch, weddings with a personal touch, corporate events with a personal touch. Please call us today for all your party rental needs, 740-689-6991.
Come experience the Huddle Tire difference. Locally owned and operated since 1910, we're your independent tire and auto repair shop. We carry all major brands of tires, including Goodyear, Cooper, BF Goodrich, and many more. But we're more than just tires. From safety inspections to alignments, brakes, shocks, and struts, even preventive maintenance, we can handle it all. Enjoy the ride at Huddle Tire Company, 300 South Columbus Street, or we can be reached at our website at huddletire.com.
My name's John Hamilton, I'm 21, and I live in Lancaster. I look at the account, the dog shelter. Well, the morning we had a meeting, and then they tell you what to do. I open all windows up, I get the boys disinfected, I give dogs water, I pick up trash outside sometimes in the parking lot. Basically, I pour the water bowls out, and I fill up the water bowl, fill it up, then I put it back in there sometimes, do that, give dogs water. All the co-workers are nice back here. They're all nice. Well, people need to give dogs a chance, because dogs, you give dogs a chance, the dog will be your best friend. And dogs won't be so mean if you don't go hitting on them, but if you be nice to a dog, they'll be nice back to you. Got a black and white dog, puppy here, and I bonded with it, and it got adopted out, so I miss that dog. It's a cool dog. My dad, he like shows me how to do stuff. It's like I'm outside mowing the grass. I didn't know how to mow the grass. So my dad showed me how to mow the grass. It feels good to help my dad pay the bills in the house. So it feels good to have a job to help my dad with the bills. You can get a job, just do a good job. When your boss tells you to do something, you just go out and do it and prove to your boss you can do it. I like to work here for a long time.
Hi, I'm Rich. Welcome to Lines Auto Service.
Lines Auto Service, a full-service preventative maintenance and automotive repair center. We understand that your vehicle is essential to your everyday life, and we do our best to not only ensure your convenience, but care for your vehicle as if it was one of our own. We repair domestic and foreign vehicles and are your best choice for scheduled maintenance on your car, truck, SUV, or fleet vehicles, both new and old. Our employees are dedicated, hardworking members of this community and care about you and your vehicle long after you leave. Lines Auto Service is family-owned and operated and uses the latest in diagnostic equipment to guarantee your vehicle is serviced correctly. We use only quality replacement parts, and our expert team of ASE-certified technicians will treat you with courtesy and respect. Stop by and see us at Lines Auto Service, 268 North Broad Street in Bremen, and we'll look forward to calling you our friend.
The Atom Board is prevention.
The Atom Board works every day to help people recover from substance abuse in Fairfield County.
The Atom Board has been an invaluable partner in our efforts against illegal drugs in our community.
The Atom Board is helping us work towards a better future here in Fairfield County. They're helping us save lives.
The Fairfield County Atom Board is honored and proud to be able to serve thousands of individuals and families in our community.
Almost everyone needs a car to get from point A to point B, and many families have two or more cars. At Carriage Company, located at 1031 North Memorial Drive in Lancaster, we specialize in hard-to-find used cars. Due to the recent success of the new car market, there is a large inventory of used cars available for resale. We can help you find exactly what you're looking for. With over 15 years at this location and 27 years experience in the business, we are the best place to go to find your next car, truck, van, or SUV. As a member of the Better Business Bureau, we are a Carfax Advantage dealer and offer great financing rates through a local area bank with warranties available on most vehicles. We know your time is valuable, so we take special pride in making sure that you get what you came for at a price that you can afford.
Come into the Carriage Company and check out our sweet deals.
Stop by today and let us help you, or visit us online at carriagecompany.com.
Sweet!
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Basketball Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, Standing Stone Bank, Sheridan Funeral Home, Fairfield National Bank, The Huddle Tire Company, Fairfield DD, Personal Touch Party Rentals, The Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, The Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Lines Auto Service, The Carriage Company, Kumler Collision,
Adam H., Dagger Law,
Kurt Bryan Lawn Care, and Infinitely Outdoors.
Welcome back to Falcon Gymnasium. We're at halftime. The Fairfield Union Lady Falcons taking on the Bloom Carroll Lady Bulldogs. Your halftime score, Fairfield Union 22, Bloom Carroll 15. Taking a look at some first half scoring. First of all, for the Bulldogs, it was Mackenzie Mason with 2 points. Maddie Wyant came in off the bench and scored 4. Chloe Davis had 4. And Alexis Birchfield led the way for the Bulldogs with 5. For Fairfield Union, it was Natalie Thurston with 2. Katie Isles had 3. Katie Burke with 2. Catherine Qualls had 1. Hannah Burnside with 3. And Maylin Sunkel led the way. She had a great first half with 11 points. A first half that saw Bloom Carroll really with a slow start, but that second period they really picked up. When Maddie Wyant came in, able to handle the ball a little better, they got it up the floor a little better.
Yeah, and, you know, you got to look at it as a positive from Coach Little's perspective. They won the quarter, Jared,
yeah.
13-12, and you got to take that and then try to build on it here. The first 5 minutes of this quarter may determine the basketball game. I've been a big believer the end of a half, first half, and the beginning of a second half a lot of times determine a basketball game.
Of course, these two teams meeting for the final time this season. Last meeting was January 8th at Bloom Carroll. Fairfield Union won that one 58-45. See Coach Little over there talking to one of the officials. I guess he's telling him, this is when I want to call timeout, this is how I'm going to do it. It's good that they can, you know, laugh
Absolutely.
About that stuff. And the thing of it is they've gotten it right every time.
That's
they've
exactly
they've
right.
corrected the mistake. And
That's going to happen. And
yeah.
as you said, they're getting it right.
Yep. Sunkel gets it over to Gornall. Now to Thurston. Shot no good for Qualls. Nice little jumper right there from the baseline for Cora Gornall. One of the seniors. Cora headed to the U.S. Air Force Academy after high school. There's a shot put up. Megan Robinson scores it.
Now that's really one of the few times in their half-court offense they've gotten a good look and finished it also. So that's real positive for Bloom Carroll.
Isles goes right side, gets it down in the corner. Now back over to Qualls. Qualls, tough shot, no good. Birchfield the rebound.
See, when you play on one side of the floor and never get the ball reversed, you don't break down the help.
Yeah. Pass stolen away, tied up. Ooh, are they going to call foul?
Yes.
We call foul on Chloe Davis. That's her second.
You know, good officials, and I want to make sure this is taken the right way, but if there's no advantage gain, they let the game play on, and it's good to have
sure.
rhythm. But once there's an advantage gain, she knocked the ball loose. You know, he called that she had grabbed it. I think he was going to let it go.
Yeah.
And that's just being patient as an official.
Isles drives baseline, puts it up. No good. Rebounded by Bloom Carroll.
Again, the ball never got reversed. You're not going to have good offensive possessions if you do not reverse the basketball from side to side.
Both teams have scored one bucket here in this second half. 24-17 is the score. Birchfield will get it over to Davis. Now back to Birchfield. Alexis on the drive. She'll kick it back out. Robinson thought about the three, and a travel going to be called on Chloe Davis.
Yeah, she changed pivot feet in the post.
Chloe's a 6'1" sophomore. She's got nice size for that post player.
Little zone now. Coach Little's going to show a little zone look here. They've had two good possessions in their man defense, but guess what? They got a turnover. And Fairfield Union's really sluggish in their half-court offense right now.
A lob just a little too far out of the reach of Natalie Thurston.
You know, just like not reversing the ball and driving into traffic, a quick throw to the post. They're trying to get it too quick, Jared, and you score more points when you're patient.
Uh-oh. Nice job on the steal there by Cora Gornall. She kind of read that one all the way. Then she lost it out of bounds. It was a long pass. She saw it coming.
She sure did. And it's too long.
Yeah.
You want to make passes should be 10 to 12 feet apart in your half-court offense. Now, you can widen that versus pressure if you have really good ball handlers, but you really would like to live by the rule of 10 to 12 feet.
Three-point attempt put up. No good for Ireland. Rebounded by Isles. She'll get it over to Sunkel. Now right side, Gornall.
A little 2-3 defense here from the Bulldogs.
Here's Thurston back to Sunkel. Back out to Isles. Quick pass inside. Nice job by Chloe Day. Or check that. That was Elena Ireland on the tie-up. So the jump ball gives it back to the Bulldogs. Hannah Burnside checks back in for Fairfield Union. When she came into the ball game earlier, she hit a quick three. It's a good-looking shot. 24-17 the score right now. Falcons on top of the Bulldogs. Here's Birchfield. Puts it up and in.
Took her time. Finished.
Staying in it. Down by five, 24-19. Thurston. Not sure if she heard somebody saying they were open inside. Threw it right into the hands of Bloom Carroll. Wyant to Birchfield.
See, the ball stopped, Jared.
Yep.
And there you go. You got to keep it moving. Keep the ball moving.
Birchfield drives to the block, puts it up, no good. Rebounded by Catherine Qualls. Birchfield's a pretty tough player. She's pretty quick on her feet. She scored 7 points so far to lead Bloom Carroll. That was a tough shot there that she took, though. Here's Burnside. Gets it over to Sunkel. Nice dump inside to Thurston. She couldn't finish. And a whistle and a foul going to be called on Fairfield Union.
That was a really nice look.
They called that one on Qualls. That's her first. Birchfield to bring it up. Guarded by Natalie Thurston. Here's Wyant. She'll fire up a three from the corner, and no good. Thurston, the only one over there for the rebound.
Well, you're not going to get offensive rebounds if you pass it once and shoot it.
Gornall, jumper no good. And a whistle and a foul as Birchfield was trying to take off quickly. Burnside going to be called for it. Katie Burke going to check back in for the Falcons. .419, 3:16 to play here in this third quarter. Wyant being worked on by Sunkel. Now Katie Burke picks her up and tips it out of bounds. Almost had the steal. You might have been able to hear Coach Little. He's saying, we've got to go. We can't wait for you. Talking about getting his girls moving. Not a lot of movement, just standing around. Here's a shot put up and in by Chloe Davis.
Yeah, Chloe a little more aggressive that time. Got to her left shoulder and turned and put it up soft.
24-21, just a three-point lead for Fairfield Union. They've only scored 2 points in this third quarter. Being outscored 6-2. Burt, quick ball movement around. Sunkel will fire up the three. That ends the drought.
She's the answer offensively for the Falcons.
Birchfield the other way. Sees a wide open shot. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Qualls. Here's Burke. Nice pass.
Real nice.
To Sunkel. Up and in. And Coach Little going to call a timeout.
And that's a legitimate timeout, too.
Nice shot there for Maylin Sunkel. And, Tim, we have some more sponsors we want to say thank you to.
Your community newspaper, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, gives you news, weather, sports, and so much more at LancasterEagleGazette.com. For up-to-date game stats, look for them on Twitter at #EagleGazette. And let's say thanks to Standing Stone Bank. Whether you're ready to tackle a mortgage loan or need cash for home improvements, make Standing Stone Bank the key player in your home or business financial plans. Business to business, neighbor to neighbor. Let's grow this town together. Standing Stone Bank, an equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Well, just less than a minute ago, I said that Bloom Carroll was outscoring Fairfield Union 6-2 in this quarter. Well, now it's Fairfield Union 7-6 in this quarter. Led by Maylin Sunkel's 5 points. 29-21, just over 2 minutes to play in the third. Mason gets it inside, and a whistle and a foul going to be called. I believe they're going to get Thurston. They call it on Qualls. No, they do call it on Thurston. Inbound pass comes into Mason. Now Wyant and Birchfield. Wyant thought about the three, drives inside the paint. Nice drive from Maddie Wyant. Couldn't get the shot to go. Here's Katie Burke, the rebound. Looks it up ahead. Nice pass, and Burnside will finish it.
Katie's giving him a big spark coming in here, Jared. Led to two scores.
Yep.
And she's only a freshman, I believe.
That's right. Started the year on JV and was moved up pretty early into the season. They saw that she was going to be needed on the varsity.
Well, she showed good vision up the floor right there, keeping her head up and looking down the floor.
Birchfield gets it over to Mason. Now it's stolen away on the pass. 10-point lead for Fairfield Union. Burnside. Out to Thurston. Her shot's good.
Wow.
Boy, they've gone on a roll here. 33-21.
Sure, yeah, getting aggressive and just a better rhythm they have here.
They're on a 10-0 run right now. Inside of 1 minute to play in the third quarter. Birchfield in the corner. Gets it to Davis. Her shot no good. Rebounded by Thurston. Thurston looks up ahead, sees Burnside open. And now Hannah will just bring it out. Give it to Sunkel. Down to 20 seconds to play in the third.
Yeah, against that 2-3, just hold it till the last second.
Burnside fires up a three. No good. Mason the rebound. Down to 10 seconds. Mason is fouled on the pass by Katie Burke.
See, that's what happens. If you run it down to the end of the half, then you have the last play. But look at Katie Burke looking up the floor right there. And a good job of running the floor and finishing also. Yep. Look right here. Look at the jump shot. I love it, how confident she shot that. Totally focused.
Yep. Replay is brought to you by Kumler Collision. 3 seconds to play. Stolen away. Here's Burnside down to one. And no good. But a nice little run there late in the third quarter to give Fairfield Union a 12-point lead, 33-21.
Nice surge at the end of the quarter for the Falcons to, you know, gain some space here in this game.
And, Tim, we wanted to remind our viewers that next week we're going to have a dandy on the air. Next Friday night we'll be out of Bloom Carroll as the boys will match up. Fairfield Union and Bloom Carroll will be a rematch of the Packed House game that we saw here just a little less than a month ago.
Could very well be the deciding game for the league championship next Friday night. You know, I don't like to presume anything. Yeah. I've been on the other end of that before. But pretty good chance that that's going to be a league championship type. And you know what the atmosphere is going to be like. Two very good basketball teams, well-coached and well-respected.
Let's talk about this league. Since we're doing a girls game, let's talk about the girls in the Mid-State League Buckeye. Of course, Amanda Clear Creek just having a phenomenal year this year. They come in tonight 19-2 and 12-1 in the league.
Yeah, and right behind them, Liberty Union 17-3 coming into tonight and 11-2 record. They split during the year, and Liberty put it on them pretty good the last time. So, you know, Amanda's probably going to win the league because they play a Hamilton team that has not won a game tonight. But congrats to both those schools. And as we mentioned earlier, Circleville, Fairfield Union, Bloom Carroll, right in the pack right below them. It's been a very, very competitive league.
All those teams, the top, the top five or six in the league, all with winning overall records. So we go into the final 8 minutes to play here at Falcon Gymnasium, 33-21. Falcons on top of the Bulldogs. Same players remain in the game for Fairfield Union that ended the third quarter. Now a whistle, and Coach Stedman will call a timeout as he saw his player trapped.
And let's also give a shout-out, Jared. Tomorrow at noon, the eighth grade Lady Falcons, I guess, you know, I really look at them as baby Falcons, the IS. Look for them. They play one of the Taze Valley middle schools. I can't remember whether it was West or East. And championship. So if you're not doing anything at noon tomorrow, get out and check out the 8th grade girls Mid-State League championship. Should be quite a ball game.
So Coach Stedman called the timeout. So the Falcons will have the basketball. Sunkel will inbound.
That was a good call from a coaching standpoint right there. This possession, you can either make or break them a little bit here. Bloom Carroll's gone back to their man defense.
Burnside gets it over to Molendick.
See, better reversal now. Ball got swung, and this is what you do. You don't want to go to the corner and pick the ball up. That's no man's land down there. See, look at Katie get it swung right there from the top, get it swung. That's real good movement, Jared. You're forcing the defense to guard the width of the floor.
Thurston's shot no good. Rebounded by Bloom Carroll.
That's a good possession with the exception of you just didn't get a score.
Birchfield dumping inside to Davis and lost the basketball, but right into the hands of her teammate, Madeline Nye, but her shot doesn't go. Officials down there talking to the sheriff's deputies who caught the basketball. Actually, one of those sheriff's deputies is Sean Burke. We talked about Katie Burke and Coach Scott Burke and, of course, Coach Gary Burke. Well, Katie's uncle Sean here tonight, too, doing some duty.
Say it's like a 60s TV show, a family affair, right?
I think so.
Yeah.
Here's Katie Burke from the deep in the corner, three-pointer up and in.
Well, somebody other than her dad has taught her to shoot, so.
I think it was her mom.
Yeah, well.
There's Sean on the right there, Deputy Sean Burke. 36-21, Falcons over Bloom Carroll.
Good movement.
In the corner, Vollmer's three no good. Nice rebound on the backside, but shot no good. And Bloom Carroll doing a nice job on the offensive boards. Three-point attempt put up. No good for Wyant.
That's a good possession, though, Jared, for the Bulldogs.
Got a lot of good-looking shots.
They did. They moved the ball. They just didn't make the shots. And that comes in the offseason when you spend time at it.
Nice kick out. Shot put up and in. Good looking shot there for Ava Molendick.
Yeah, but I like the pitch. You know, Ava stuck it in, which, you know, put the ball in the hole, and that's important. But I really love the penetrating kick.
38-21. Nice little drive and shot there for Madeline Nye. Back the other way, Hannah Burnside.
She's running the floor really well. Yeah. She's done that tonight. Had a good job of getting out and running the floor and getting some easy baskets.
40-23. Good dump inside and finish.
Yeah, really good look from Burnside. She snapped that ball in there.
And a timeout going to be called by Coach Little. And the official says, "You sure?
Yeah.
Did you really call one this time?" Here's a replay.
I said Burns, I meant Birchfield. Yeah, look at that pitch. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
That's beautiful basketball, Jared. Shooter ready, hand set.
So with this timeout, Tim, we have another sponsor we want to say thank you to.
Let's say thanks to Infinitely Outdoors. They provide a complete design center for all your outdoor needs, including design and build services for soft and hardscapes. They also design and build water features. Need rocks? Holy, pink, green, black? They have them. Infinitely Outdoors is conveniently located at 450 West Fair Avenue across from Goodwill, where they take the comforts of the inside out.
So 5:04 to play here in this Mid-State League Buckeye Division girls matchup. Fairfield Union leads it 40-25. Boy, Bloom Carroll had this one to within three late in that third quarter, and Fairfield Union's just gone on a run.
The end of that third quarter, that surge, that 10-0 surge, just has really widened the gap. And now you can even tell the confidence. And I'll say this, the Fairfield Union's been able to use his bench and relatively maintain or even increase leads. And that's a big advantage that you have when you have players that do that for you, Jared.
It'll be Falcon basketball. Bloom Carroll going to come with some full court pressure. Burke inbounds it, gets it to Burnside. Now left side, it's Gornall. Now back out to Burke. Here's Burnside. Nice little give and go there. Now pass back out, but it's away from Katie Burke and goes out of bounds.
Yeah, right idea right there. Just didn't execute it very well, but that was the right idea.
There's a steal. Josephine Burke this time. Here's Burnside.
See, they're getting the ball moved. Now there's nobody on the wing over there to get it moved. There you go. So you got to create spacing and you got to create opportunities to catch the ball.
Roush gets it into Burke. Now back out to Gornall. Dump back into Josephine Burke again. Nice move, but her shot's blocked by Davis and picked up by Mason. Mason quickly up the floor, goes all the way, puts it up and in.
Coast to coast.
Mackenzie Mason with the finish, 40-27 now.
But Katie sees the ball,
yes,
the floor
does.
So well.
Nice pass over to Burnside.
And I like how unselfish the girls are. Yep. They give it up and somebody else to get past. But Katie sees the floor really well, Jared.
Fairfield Union now with eight players in the scoring column. They're spreading it around tonight. There's a pass over to Nicole Bradbury. Now it's Nye, back to Mason. Mason drives it, no good, blocked by Burke, and she picks it up, gives it off to Katie Burke. Katie over to Gornall, her shot no good. And Fulmer needs help. She picked up her dribble. Mason now across the timeline. Down to 3:02 to play here in this ball game. Nice pass over to Chloe Davis. Who
Real
scores
nice.
It.
Nice look.
Burnside running the floor. Dishes off to Gornall. Shot no good, but Gornall hustles for her own rebound. Then it's tied up. And it'll go to Bloom Carroll.
can see here, this was the where she goes coast to coast. It's a dribbling exhibition, actually. She did a nice job of handling the ball and the finish over a player that's a little bigger. That's pretty impressive. Coach Barr getting excited over there.
Just reminding them, we don't need to score. They're sprinting it up the floor and still trying to get some buckets.
You know, those are fine lines. When you've played a tempo game.
Three put up an end.
Here you go. It's back to a 10-point game.
Nicole Bradbury.
And a turnover.
Yep. And quickly, Coach Stedman will get Maylin Sunko off the bench and back into the ball game.
But back to the point, Jerry, when you play that way and you play tempo, there's a fine line in teaching and understanding about when then do we back it off and how. And then, you know, that's part of the process of the learning and teaching angle that you got to have.
Stolen away by Sunko.
Imagine that.
Yeah. Maylin can't score, but she's going to the free throw line. Foul is called on Allie Thompson. Sunko's free throw up and good. She's hit two of them there tonight so far. Make that three. Second one no good. Rebounded by Birchfield. And her pass is tipped, and it'll go out of bounds, but it'll stay with the Bulldogs. .43-32, 2:12 to play in the ball game. Birchfield spins to the elbow. Here's Chloe Davis. Nice move.
What I liked is she had to go to her left, Jared. Now she finished with her right, but that's a nice move from the high post for a tall girl.
And stolen away momentarily. Josephine Burke picks it up. And a timeout going to be called by Coach Stedman. 43-34. Bloom Carroll fighting. They're trying to stay in this one.
Well, went to the pressure, and, you know, the game's been called, you know, relatively what I would say to a point where the girls are, you know, not going to call every little slap ticky-tack foul. Yeah. You got to be strong with the basketball. And, you know, we've seen that a lot tonight, especially with the younger players, is they don't do a fantastic job of protecting the basketball. And when we talk about that, we mean getting both hands on it, being stronger with the ball. And that happens as they get older. But that's one of the areas that you'd like to see younger players improve.
1:50 to play in the ball game, and now's just as good a time as any to name our players of the game. First of all, for Fairfield Union, our Fairfield Union player of the game, brought to you by Fairfield National Bank. At Fairfield National Bank, we believe a strong community is built with local volunteers, donations, and leadership. Last year, Fairfield National Bankers supported 183 local organizations like youth clubs, social services, animal protection groups, schools, health organizations, nature centers, and more. It's an honor to be a part of the good things happening every day in towns where we live and work. Fairfield National Bank invites you to join us this year and find new ways to support your community, too. Fairfield National Bank is a division of the Park National Bank, member FDIC.
Well, I say, Jared, Fairfield Union spreads it around, do a good job, but I think the straw that stirs the drink is Maylin Sunko, and I think Maylin's the player of the game tonight for the Falcons.
Couldn't agree with you more. Number 20, Maylin Sunko. Congratulations, our Fairfield Union player of the game. We'll get to the Bloom Carroll player of the game momentarily. There is Maylin with the basketball. They'll quickly get it up the floor to Isles. Now to Josephine Burke. Her pass is stolen away by Allie Thompson. Down in the corner, three-pointer put up, in and out for Nicole Bradbury, who just hit one earlier. Still a 9-point game, 43-34, minute 21 and counting. And a whistle and a foul going to be called on Alexis Birchfield. That'll be her second. And they still have fouls to give.
Well, I think we only had 8 fouls in the first half. So, as I said, the officials have let them play tonight, which has been fine. It's been consistent. And it's been even. Not a lot of complaining from anybody.
Right.
So, you know, the game's better when things that are not, you know, where you don't gain advantage because it keeps the game in rhythm.
Burnside gives it right side to Gornall. Cora now to Sunkel. Down to a minute to play in the game. And Coach Little calling out fire. That means foul.
That's right. Not on purpose.
It was called on Haley Vollmer, her first. Ball comes into Sunkel, and a foul going to be called now on Mackenzie Mason.
Well, when you know as an official, that's a good job there by calling. When you know the other coach wants the foul, call the foul.
Yeah.
You know, give it to him and get him in that situation. Unfortunately, with 50 seconds to go, your chances aren't really going to be very good.
Right. And a foul this time going to be called, I believe, again on Mackenzie Mason. Still have another one to give. And let's go ahead and get to our Bloom Carroll player of the game, brought to you by Lines Auto, located at 268 North Broad Street in Bremen. Open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., or visit them online at www.linesauto.com.
Well, Jared, looking it over, I thought Maddie Wyatt came in and gave him a big lift, but I think the player that's been most consistent when you look at both ends of the floor for the Bulldogs has been Chloe Davis. She's blocked shots, she's got some rebounds, and she scored in double figures.
Right.
And they really, Bloom Carroll doesn't have anybody really that scores in double figures.
Shot put up no good for Bloom Carroll. Here's Birchfield now. Her shot's no good, gets her own rebound. Kicks it out, three-pointer put up, and in for Nicole Bradbury. That's two threes in this quarter for Nicole. And a quick timeout going to be called by Bloom Carroll as it's 43-37 now. How about that?
Never say die.
That's right.
You got to really praise their kids for continuing to play hard and forcing Fairfield Union to execute. You know, you just had an over and back on an out of bounds play, because coming up to the tournament, there's no next day.
Right.
So you got to keep continuing to work hard, try to get better, improve, and sometimes that improvement is just an understanding the part of the game, not the physical part of it necessarily, but the mental part.
So 26.2 seconds to play in the ball game. Bloom Carroll has scratched and clawed their way back into it. 43-37 is the score. Fairfield Union on top. And the next foul that they commit will put Fairfield Union at the line, which is what they want.
Exactly. And you got to make sure now, for Fairfield Union, this is a good case right now. Execute the out-of-bounds play and get it to your best free throw shooter.
Yeah.
Understand how to do that. That determines games a lot of times. Not just to get it in, but get it to the right person.
As a team, Fairfield Union looks like just 52.7%. Can that be right? From the free throw line?
I don't know. I didn't quite interpret. That's not that unrealistic. See right there, you got the Mae Lynn.
You're Fairfield Union, that's who you want to have the ball.
That's a good job on their part to execute this late. Now, whether it determines the game or not, but this is good because later they might have a game where they need to do this. And, you know, we just talked about her making two free throws with no time last week against Circleville.
Yeah.
So those are critical type things that you can use for teaching right now.
Sunko at the line. She's a 64% free throw shooter. She's hit 3 of 4 there tonight. First one's up and good.
Yeah, and you know, the last one, I thought she just kind of didn't really stay with it the whole time, and she missed it. But her focus right there on that's perfect.
Second one also good. Give her 19 points in the ball game. 45-37, 22 seconds to play in the game. Here's Thompson, quickly up the floor for Bloom Carroll, and loses it out of bounds. It'll go back to Fairfield Union.
Yeah, valiant effort here, but the clock's going to get him here, Jared.
Madeline Nye checks back in for Bloom Carroll. Long pass coming into Sunkwit midcourt. She jumped right out of her shoe. Now she just picks it up and throws it into the stands. She'll play the last 10 seconds with no shoe.
Good effort.
Three-pointer put up and in for Allie Thompson.
Oh, my gosh.
45-40 after the three-pointer by Allie Thompson. But how about Maylin Sunkel? She jumped for the pass and jumped right out of her shoe.
Oh, my gosh.
Then played the last 10 seconds without it.
And she contested the shot in the corner and made a great effort.
She did. So Bloom Carroll hit a big three there, but still just 5 points difference. Going to be tough in 2.8 seconds.
Yeah, they've had the last really good 2.5-3 minutes here, Jared, with their pressure playing full court, getting open, and then continuing to play and play hard. Got to admire Matt. Like you said, that's a young team with only one senior.
Yeah.
And that's what you look for.
Yeah, looking down the scoring column, I mean, you know, the players that have scored in this ball, they've got a lot of freshmen on this team and sophomores.
It's very young, and like I said, they have an outstanding JV team that's had a great year, so at competition level, Bloom Carroll's going to be really good for the girls' team next year.
Of course, you look at Fairfield Union, they've got sophomores doing a lot of their scoring. Maylin Sunkel's just a junior. Katie Burke's a freshman.
Yeah, they'll have a nice core coming back also of players. Now, those three seniors will be missed. You can tell they provide leadership.
Right.
And when you have to pull four grades together, Jared, you know, a lot of times you're dealing with specifically your top two grades and maybe some sophomore. When you got to pull four grades together, that takes some cooperation on your kids and understanding and knowing that, you know, your seniors have to just provide that leadership. There you go. See, she was open.
Davis kicks it.
Yeah, Maylin's working to get the ball here. Again, you say, well, it doesn't matter. Well, it does because it may play later in a situation in a tournament. Passers got to use pass fakes.
Inbound comes in to Thurston, and she is fouled by Mackenzie Mason.
Yeah, not as an official, you just don't want to have to call that at this point, but it is.
It's going to be four on Mackenzie and sends Natalie Thurston to the free throw line. She'll shoot 1-1. Thurston, a 55.2% free throw shooter. With 1 second on the clock. And no good. And time's going to run out on Bloom Carroll. As the Fairfield Union Falcons win this one 45-40 over Bloom Carroll. But I tell you what, give Coach Little and his crew a lot of credit. They stuck around, you know, when it looked like they were dead in the water. They fought back.
They did. And the Falcons surged them there at the end of the third quarter and the start of the fourth and built that lead. Then got a little inconsistent themselves. And like you said, credit to Coach Little's group. You know, I think you look at both these teams, next year is going to be an interesting race again, Jared.
Let's quickly run down the scoring. First of all, for Bloom Carroll was Mackenzie Mason with 4. Allie Thompson had 3. Megan Robinson had 2 points. Nicole Bradbury had 6. Maddie Wyatt with 4. Madeline Nye had 2 points. It was Haley Vollmer with 2. Alexis Birchfield had 7. And our Bloom Carroll player of the game, Chloe Davis, had 10 points to lead the Bulldogs. For Fairfield Union, it was Natalie Thurston with 4. Katie Isles had 3. Katie Burke had 5. Cora Gornall had 2. It was Ava Mullendick with 2. Catherine Qualls had 1. Hannah Burnside had 9. And leading the way, leading all scorers, Maylin Sunkel with just a phenomenal game tonight, scoring 19 points.
Very impressive, Maylin. Just does a lot of things, and I like her zest for the game also. She got a lot of deflections defensively. She got some steals. She passes the ball well.
Yep.
She just does a lot of things well, and, you know, she'll take this offseason and continue to work to get better. She's going to be a really dynamic player next year in the league.
Want to say thanks to our crew tonight, Jim Spires and James Kirchgessner on cameras, and our production crew tonight, Bob Campetti, Shane Messina, and Aaron Uhl. We want to invite you to join us next Friday night. We'll be at Bloom Carroll as the Bloom Carroll Bulldogs will face off with the Fairfield Union Falcons in what could be, as you mentioned, a battle for the Mid-State League Buckeye Division Championship. Here tonight, your final score, Fairfield Union 45, Bloom Carroll 40 in girls action. For Tim Shoemaker and all of our crew, I'm Jared Stewart. Have yourselves a great night, everybody.
IVP Sports has brought you the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Basketball Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, Standing Stone Bank, Sheridan Funeral Home, Fairfield National Bank, The Huddle Tire Company,